Welcome back, gang. In this episode, we're going to start taking a look at the user profile. Now, what we want to achieve is having the URL be user profile at slash, and then it'll be the username. So the first thing we want to do is head over to our text editor, and we'll go to web roots. Now, in the group root that we set up, I think it was last episode, maybe a couple episodes ago, we're going to add a new root. So it'll be root get profile. And that's going to be part of the URL. So it'll be user for the group profile. And then we're going to go ahead and add in the controller that we already set up early on, which will be profile. Profile, okay, try this one more again. Profile controller, and we want to make sure to import that class, and the method that we'll be using is show, and we're also going to name it profiles.show, and don't forget the semicolon. Now, as I said earlier, we're going to be using the username as part of the URL. By doing this way, we'll be using root model binding, and how we accomplish that is by doing it like this. We'll go ahead and add the model that we want to use, because the user's username is in the user model on the users table. So we want to make sure to add that here. Now, in order to get this to work properly, if we just use user, Laravel will automatically look for the ID on the user table, which is not what we want. We want the user field from the table. So we need to specify it here. Now, there are multiple ways of doing this. This I found is just the easiest way that works for me. So there's that. Okay, so now let's go to the controller, which is profile controller. And in the show method, we need to change now the variable from ID to user. User. Go ahead and make sure that's imported. And then add the variable of user. The other thing you can do too is to change the param. So it'll be app models user and then the variable. Okay, so in this method, what we'll be looking to do is insert the view, which we haven't created yet. We'll want Inertia to render the view for us. So we'll return Inertia render. Now, the view that we're going to create is in a folder called user, that's in a folder called profile, and then the view itself, which will be show, and we'll do comma, open brackets, because we're actually going to be putting in an array of information. Okay, so the one that we'll be working with today, the prop, is profile, and then we'll add the variable of user. And we'll add a comma there for now. So let's go up top and make sure that user and inertia are both brought into the imports. Okay, great. So now let's go ahead and create this. We'll go down to resources, JS, pages, and then this profile here is the one that came with the default installation that houses everything for the update, the edit, and everything for the user. So we're going to want to create this separately anyway. So in the pages folder, this is a little shortcut that I learned along the way, and I'll show it to you now. So this will be the first folder. The next folder will be profile. And then now we can go ahead and add the view, show.view. Okay. And see, now that created both folders for us and the show.view. Now, What we want to do is go ahead and add the template. Oh. Try that again. Okay, in here for now we'll just put profile, just so that we can make sure it works. The other thing is we need to bring in our JavaScript. And then in our JavaScript, we need to add the prop that we just sent to this page from the controller, which is profile. Okay. So now we'll go to user, profile, and the user that we're logged in is the username, it's test. Oh, profiles, test. Oh no, it was profile. Okay, refresh. And then we'll open up our inspection tools and see what we have here. Okay, so this was already brought in. Great. Inspect. And we're going to take a look at our view dev tools. So view. Okay, and then we'll be able to open up Inertia, go to show, and now you see already pulled in is our profile object, which is exactly what we want. Okay. So now, in order to style this, essentially we're just going to grab from the dashboard page because we already have, it's going to be pretty much the same. So we'll copy this and then we'll make adjustments as we go along. So add this to the show page. Paste. And now we need to bring in this pages layout component that we created. So pages or import pages layout from at layouts slash pages layout. Okay, so now under this prop that we have here, we'll add components. Curly braces, and then we'll add pages layout. Okay, what we want to change here is now, since we have the profile prop coming in, we can just go ahead and change this now to profile. And we'll do the same one for this one, profile username. Okay, now let's go ahead and refresh and make sure we didn't break anything. And we can go ahead and close this. Okay, great. So now we want to change this also, because it's not the dashboard page. So what we're going to do is add some curly braces. Then we're going to have backticks, dollar sign, curly braces, and in the curly braces we're going to add profile.username outside of the backtick, or outside of the first curly brace for this thing here, for the profile user, we're going to add an apostrophe S, because this will be the profile user. Sorry, we want to add username. The username's profile. And then we actually want this profile inside of the backticks. Okay, so now we should be good. Let's go ahead and check and make sure that that worked. Okay, great. So this is our test profile. So now the other thing we can change in here is now give this a proper link. So we'll go to our sidebar component, sidebar, and then we can go ahead and change the link. So we'll go colon, And then in here, we'll add route. And then we'll add profiles show, because that's the name of the route. And please make sure that this is profiles.show, because in this default profile folder, this show method is linked to profile.show, and that's just with the default installation. So we want to make sure that this says profiles.show. Okay, and then we'll add the parameter for that route, which is the username. So we'll go page props user username. Okay, now let's test that out, make sure it works. Refresh. Okay, and if you hover over it, you see at the bottom left that that is the correct route that we're looking for, the URL. Okay, which we're already on that page, so, well, we can try it this way. Go to dashboard, go to test, and now we're at test profile. Okay, so that'll wrap it up for today, guys. The next episode, we're going to start working with bringing in users. This way we can go from users page to users page and just do a bunch of other things, because we still need to add friendships. There are a bunch of other things we need to do with other users, as it is a social network. Okay, so please be patient with me. We're getting through it. You guys are doing great. I will see you next time. I'm going to go ahead and push this code up to GitHub. Thanks for watching. See you next time.